And I read them a poem that I was given one time when I was going to talk, and somebody said to me, there were several other speakers, and what are you talking about? I said, I'm talking about the Holocaust. Oh, he said, I happen to have this friend who's a teacher who wrote this poem. You might be interested. I read the poem, and since then I always read it, and I have copies of it if you'd like to take. And so I read the poem to the kids. It's called Courage, and the teacher who wrote this, his name is Bob Blue. And it goes like this. A small thing once happened at school that brought up a question for me, and somehow it forced me to see the price that I pay to be cool. Diane is a girl that I know. She's strange, like she doesn't belong. I don't mean to say that that's wrong. We don't like to be with her, though. And so when we all made a plan to have this big party at Sue's, most kids in our school got the news, but no one invited Diane. The thing about Taft Junior High is secrets don't last very long. I acted like nothing was wrong when I saw Diane start to cry. I know that you think that I'm cruel and it doesn't make me feel very proud. I just went along with the crowd. It's sad, but you have to at school. You can't pick the friends you prefer. You fit in as well as you can. I couldn't be friends with Diane because then they would treat me like her. Remember, if you help a Jew, you will be treated like a Jew. In one class at Taft Junior High, we study what people have done with gas chamber bomber and gun at Auschwitz, Japan, and my lie, and I don't understand all I learned. Sometimes I just sit there and cry. The whole world stood idly by to watch as the innocent burned, like robots obeying some rule, following orders. Atrocities done by the mob, all innocent, doing their job. And what was it for? Was it cool? The world was aware of this hell, but nobody cried out in shame. No heroes and no one to blame. A story that no one dared tell. I promise to do what I can to not let it happen again. To care for all women and men, I'll start by inviting Diane. Right. Now, more recently, I have added another piece to my presentation. And this was written by an adolescent high school student by the name of Jordan Clark, a relative of one of our what do you call them? What do you call them? Program associates. On September 13th, my, quote, food and culture, quote, close quote, teacher instructed us to create a recipe for something other than food. September the 11th was on my mind. I was confused when I learned that the men who had murdered so many were at one time ordinary people with families, hopes, and dreams. I wondered how they could carry out such an evil act. I decided to create a recipe for evil. Recipe for evil. Preparation time, 1 hour to a lifetime. Serving size, 1 serving per million people. Utensils, schools, places of worship, and homes. Pour 2 cups of stereotyping, 1 cup of prejudice, and 1 cup of hate into a bowl and mix together. Slice anger into chunks and place in a bowl. Place a handful of jealousy and fear into a pot and simmer. Melt some ignorance into the simmering pot. Break up a clove of violence, a teaspoon of misunderstanding, and a tablespoon of misguidedness, and mix. Add propaganda and bring to a boil. Once all the ingredients are mixed, soften, sprinkle in a bit of relentlessness, and serve hot. The higher the heat, the stronger the evil will be. With these ingredients, Even the best people can force groups or individuals out of their universe of obligation, dehumanize them, and commit acts of evil like those we experienced on September 11th.